Alan Sakula, had suggested I revisit my archive of Jackson and look at it through the lens of race, gender, and class. And so I read Du Bois, W.B. Du Bois. I read Wretched of the Earth, Frantz Fanon, and a couple other books by Frantz Fanon. I was reading Toni Morrison. I was reading Skip Gates. I was reading bell hooks, Cornel West. You know, this a lot. Basically, it was a crash course in African American studies with a 3-month reading list. And then afterwards, I went back to my archive and I started writing, looking at photos and writing about my experience, and pretty much coming to the conclusion that Michael's change of his physical features was evidence of his distance and his shame of blackness. So that he had basically swallowed the poison pill that we're inferior, that we should be ashamed, you know, of our racialized selves and so forth. Then as I was writing this down, I realized, oh my goodness, I have a lot of those same tendencies. And that exists in my mind as well. It was a shocker, you know, like when your grandma says, when you're pointing your finger up, there's 4 fingers pointing right back at you. So that's when I really got in deeply about mental colonialism. And I know it's not on the didactics here. I'm trying to keep this open, but just so you guys, if you ever want to bring it up in the educational area, because this also informs why I went and got a studio in Africa, working in Africa, to pretty much reconnect with my own history, which I don't have any idea of past my grandparents, because nobody's going to say that they were enslaved. So, this is my third or fourth iteration of working with Michael Jackson work as art medium. And what I've done is then this is the last backstory, then I'll jump in. Good friends of mine, Carrie Mae Weems, she worked with me as my assistant when I was shooting Michael, and she did all my darkroom work. Carrie Mae was at my house 3 years ago, right before it was announced. Like a week before it was announced, she was a MacArthur Genius recipient. So she would say, "Todd, can you take my picture?" "Why?" "I just, need it for something." And then she in any event, she was at my house with a filmmaker, John Akonfra, a Ghanaian Brit filmmaker. And we were talking, and then it comes out that I was an MJ's photographer, and then John Akonfra saw some of these snapshots that I have of when I took Michael's picture to Africa, and I asked people to pose with him and ask them, "Do you know who this man is? Is he African?" You know, that's how it goes, and I'll get to that later. At that moment, the name of Stuart Hall, who, as many of you know, invented the whole genre and area of study and academics called cultural studies. You'd have no black studies, no women's studies, no African studies, no Latino studies, no studies without Stuart Hall. He invented that. Jamaican, who actually went to Britain. Okay, so he invented that whole area in the 60s. And when Carrie Mae found out I had never read anything by Stuart Hall, she was just in shock. And she gave me this mandate. She says, "Todd, you must read Stuart Hall, because he talks about power and systemic power and how power is visited upon others, specifically people of color." And she said, "As soon as you read Stuart Hall, I want you to go back to your Jackson stuff and reimagine it." So really, this exhibition is from a challenge from Carrie Mae Weems. So, and then you all can all, of course, get background on Carrie Mae, which I'm sure you know. So one thing that struck me from Stuart Hall was he was saying power is hegemonic. It's everywhere. And you can't resist absolute power like that exists with governments and so forth. And if you are a minority, you're going to get scapegoated. I mean, that's how the relationship of majority culture to minority culture. So majority culture can always be in the right. You need someone in the wrong. You know, these binaries, right, wrong, good, bad, ugly, beautiful, right, criminal, and so forth. So what Stuart Hall says, the only power that we have over to exercise our own agency is to be in a continuous state of resistance. Because once we settle, power will name that, and then it will define whatever name or whatever image we serve up. And we can textualize it to support our criminality, our otherness, our second placeness, our subjugation. So you must keep it moving, and you must resist normativity. Because normativity is where power really tries is to freeze everyone in their roles. So I thought, wow, okay, that was my challenge. To then go back, talk about my diaspora. Really, this is about me rediscovering my Africanness as my African American. And so I decided to do a mashup of my archive from Africa and works of Michael. So you might go say, like, in this one, where's Michael? This is a gang member who was an actor on the set of the Beat It video. Because Michael had actual gang members on set for Beat It. And so when you see gang members here, these were all, they were the string of connectivity for myself was that they were on the Beat It set, and I also wanted to show and highlight, you know, humanity. And so that's where also this, an honor of humanity. This is a human being. Regardless of where, what his social standing is, this is a human being. And I want to honor that. So that's how I started including images of gang members and so forth. Cosmos. All right. I discovered that, you'll see that I use the cosmos in a few of my images. And I do that because I had, after thinking hard and long, you know, Michael is supremely talented. He'll cry if you crush a fly in front of him. I mean, the most hyper sensitive individual. And I kept thinking, you know what? Michael's not from this earth. He's just not from here. And I was musing and just thinking about that. I thought, well, who else is like that? I thought, Sun Ra. Sun Ra is not from here. Sun Ra even comes out. I mean, what is he, from Saturn? Sun Ra says, he's from Saturn. So, so I thought, well, if Sun Ra can be from Saturn, then I invented an origination story for Michael, that he must be the offspring of Sun Ra, and he came from the cosmos. Because who else could have all this talent, this sensitivity, this complexity? And that was the only answer I could come up with. He couldn't be from here, because he's much too complex. So I started using the cosmos. And I also started to say, you know, we all come from the cosmos. And isn't it funny that we have such a high degree, for all of us, we could have ended up in this culture as anything, but how is it that such a high degree of us end up in poverty? How is it that such a high degree of us have limited options? And that's my, you know, as far as the universe goes, you're on your earth, you're all equal. No, it's because of systems. Systematic oppression, limited opportunity, and so forth. So I wanted to use that as a universal to talk about these tensions in society. Making is this, yeah, okay. And feel free to ask questions. Yes?
One, you mentioned about honoring the humanity of the gang member when his face is obscured. Mm-hmm. So talk about kind of that kind of
like. As you'll notice, lots of faces are obscured. That's because I don't want to make it specific. I want to be, if once I reveal the space, it becomes that person, and then you can define it. This is where I try to introduce slippage, where it's whoever you imagine is behind that, or it's a signifier for other. But I try to work more broadly. And that's why you also see there's like a, when I do use a photo of Michael, like in some of these other iterations, he's only partially shown, you know, because I don't want the audience member to look at Michael as spectacle, look at Michael as a celebrity. I want to present him as an idea, okay? That, So I have a place in West Africa. My wife and I, we have a studio in West Africa in a village called Akwida. It's in the Taprari region, Akwida. And it's a fishing village. So I started pulling images from there. This is from a funeral where they put these huge sound systems. The funerals are 3 days long. They're just wild parties, you know, really. And the universe and a wall from one of the buildings, or one of the shacks, what have you, homes. This is the mangrove. So you'll notice this image comes up quite a bit in Akwida. And just sort of talking about the performance or how we came from here and through the waterways, crossing the Atlantic, go forward a few hundred years, and we end up here with Twitter and everything else. So I did that. Waterways and things of that, the journey, you know, comes into play. And then the circles is my, I'm a professor, professor emeritus of photography from Cal State Long Beach. And so I use circles because I was thinking, why is there always a rectilinear shape for a photograph? What is that about? And that's when I decided, that's arbitrary. So I wanted to break that. I wanted to break that normativity. And that's when I started introducing circles and ovals into my work to break with that. And then I reasoned also, why do photographs have to be hung at a certain distance, at a certain height, when you can actually make them move? You can actually make a connection by moving these positions, this whole wall becomes one, and the images start moving like waves, or they bob. And so it starts opening up, I can open up broader dialogues. You'll start thinking more holistically. You'll think of the individual and then the whole, hopefully. You'll think of the individual image and then you'll also think of the whole. Yeah? These are some of the ideas that race through my mind while I'm doing this. So hence, fabrics, African fabrics again. Yinka sorbet? Yinka?
Shanabari.
You know, so of course I know about Yinka Shanabari, that's what gave me the idea to start using African fabrics as a signifier of colonialism. Because as you know, these are Dutch design fabrics that were shipped, they were made for another country, Indonesia, made for Indonesia. Indonesians didn't embrace them, so they shipped them to Africa, and now they're part of the African visual culture. I mean, it's part of how one dresses. That's a pretty complex story behind that. This hits it. So that's when I started using more fabric. And by the way, this